We're asking everyone to please silence your phones. And anyone making remarks today will make them from this podium here. Clergy will speak from the pulpit. Our condolences to the family, and we're now in the hands of Casper Funeral Home and a clergy.
Hallelujah. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet believeth in me, he shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, hallelujah, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let's bow our heads for a moment. Heavenly Father, we come before you today, celebrating the life of our dear sister, mother, wife, Linda Haynes. Father, we thank you for those that have gathered here today, Lord. Even though we are here to celebrate and that it's a homecoming service, homegoing service, we come giving you the praise, giving you the honor, and giving you the glory as we are in your house today. I'm asking that you would touch every heart today. Put hearts on fire. Father, as we reflect and remember the life of Linda Haynes, Father, I just thank you, Lord, that someone that does not know you today would come to know your power, that they would accept you as their Lord and Savior. Somebody would rededicate their life, and somebody would just continue to give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. We just commit this service into your hands. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. God bless you. And if this is your first time at Morningstar Baptist Church, we welcome you, and we pray that you would come back another time. On behalf of our Bishop John M. Borders III, First Lady Sister Sandra Borders, and our Assistant Pastor Reverend Dorothy Isles Smith, we just welcome you. We welcome you. Today we're family. We're one. And in whatever capacity that we can serve you, we are here to do that today and after today. Amen? So we pray that you would come in and feel the Spirit of the Lord. If you feel like lifting up your hands, if you feel like letting the tears roll, it's okay, because you're home today. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Most High God. At this time, we're going to follow the order of our program, our order of service, and I'm going to ask Minister Tanya Larkins Norman to come and share with us the scriptures from the Old and the New Testament. And following her, we will have a prayer of comfort from our minister, Reverend Tukes. And please hear them in that order. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I'm Tanya's husband, Pastor Norman. The allergies is really kicking in. She's coughing a lot, so thank God for a ram in the bush. Praying for the family that y'all will stay strong, knowing that God loves you so much. The scripture is coming from Proverbs 31, 26 to the 31st verse. It reads as following. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done well, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her the fruits of her hand and let her own works praise her in the gates. The word of the Lord is blessed. We're doing St. John, the 16th chapter, that's one verse, the 22nd verse. Therefore, you now have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart will rejoice, and your joy no one will take from you. May the Lord have a blessing in doing of the word. Family, be encouraged. God be for you. Who could be against you?
Morning. We do give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To you, family, I do extend my condolence to you, that God will strengthen you as you continue on your journey. Let us pray. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Father, in the precious name of Jesus, as we come today to just to say thank you, we thank you, God, for our sister Linda, how you blessed her and given her many years, oh God, among us, that we would be able to fellowship with her. And we thank you, God, today we come aside to celebrate her legacy. We asking that you remember her family right now, her companion, especially, and her children. God, we know that you're able to bring comfort in times of sorrow. You are able to dry tears and turn tears into laughter. For we know that there is a time and a season for all things. And now it is a time, a season in which we are mourning. But God, we realize that in the morning, joy will come, because you declared that weeping endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. I ask thee, O God, to undergird this family, give unto them the comfort that they need. In the midnight hours, God, when the tears began to flow, I pray that you would dry their tears. In the days when they look around, and the places where Sister Linda, they always will see her presence. God, let there be a spirit of peace that would overshadow them, letting them know that, oh God, earth has no sorrows that heaven cannot heal. We ask your blessings, God, to continue to guide and direct this family, for their lives has changed. They has entered into a new season. And it requires for a new adjustment. So, God, I'm asking you to give unto them the wisdom and the patience that they need with one another to be able to make that transition that lies ahead of them. And we thank you right now for what you have done and what you're going to do. We give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor. In Jesus' name, we thank you. Amen. I speak peace and blessings over your family. God bless you.
Hallelujah. I thank God for the scriptures that were read, and I thank God for the prayer of comfort. And I just want to say to that plan is in the way, but I want to say to John and Sarita and your other sisters and brothers, all of the family members, grandchildren, all of you family members, I know this is a difficult time, but we came to celebrate the life of Sister Linda. Are you a believer in this house today? Because, you know, we don't grieve the way that the world grieves. We thank God for the life that she lived. We come to lift up the name of Jesus through tears, through sadness, through a bowed down head. I know you're sad, but I thank God that he kept her in the land of the living all this time. I got to know her and John, and I thank God for her life. And I'd like to ask everyone except for the immediate family, if you would just stand on your feet for a moment, and we would just give God praise for today. Give God praise that he woke us up this morning, that he started us on our way, that even in the midst of tears, we can glorify the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We can praise his holy name, because we don't know what we're going to face when we leave out of this place. So while you have the opportunity, while the blood is running warm in your veins, give God the best praise. Give God thanks for this day. Hallelujah, because he didn't have to wake us up this morning, but he did. Hallelujah, we have the use and activities of our limbs. Even if you might not be able to walk or run like you used to, we can still praise him. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. And I just want to give God the praise while we have the chance. Hallelujah. You may be seated. I just thank God for each and every one of you this morning. I thank God that you are here with us to celebrate the homegoing of our dear sister, your wife, John, your mother, your grandmother. This is an honor as well as a privilege for me today. Hallelujah. We know to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And if we live a life to glorify God, we will see her again one day. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to have a solo from Demetria Young going up to yonder. Oh, you changed it. That's all right. Hallelujah. Sing.
Good morning, family. I love y'all. Can I take this down? Okay. Come up here. I'm fine right here. Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows come? And why should my heart feel lonely and long for heaven, my home?
Thank you for that beautiful selection. I thought you was going to go a little bit, I sing, you know how we do that. But thank you so much. Now this is the time when you get to participate. Remarks. Now, remarks. I know most people say, I can't say anything in 2 minutes? Oh, yes, you can. Yes, you can. So I'm going to invite you to this mic, and we will have remarks today. And I don't know if Sister Sarita designated anybody, but we normally have 4 to 5 people sharing remarks, and you can share the rest of the remarks at the repast. Is that all right? So please come. Let's begin. Tell us something, a memory or something special. Thank you.
Good morning. Amen. To Uncle John and the family, I just want to say, it's the after effect after the funeral, where people are reaching out, phone calls, showing love, making sure Pops is all right, the family's all right. Not the internet, Facebook, Snapchat, YouTube, all the other nonsense. It's about love, respect, and dignity. I lost my mother 34 years ago. Ain't nothing like a mother's love. Ain't nothing like a father's love, but a mother, that's your mother and your father. There's no reason to be sad because we're celebrating a queen. This is royalty right here among us, okay? Yeah. Ain't no need to be sad. Keep smiling, y'all the legacy. Everything they did, everything she taught you, everything she taught the world, we are allowed to go forward and teach ours. Ain't no sad faces up in here, smile, because she's all the way in heaven smiling down on you by the grace of God, amen.
Good morning, everybody. A lot of people might not know me. My name is Tanisha. Sister Liz, she is my grandmother. She adopted me. And growing up in the family, Sister Linda was one of the people who came around a lot and looked out for me and brought us food and everything. So her love and her impact was definitely felt, and I thank the family for sharing her with us.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, family. My name is Deacon Kevin Tony Mitchell. Linda and John are my brothers and sister. Those who don't know me is my brother Jamie and my sister, my sister Margaret, and rest in peace, my brother. You know, they had kids together, and you know, Nicole, and rest in peace, Cerise. That's how we became family when I was younger. You know, in the 70s, they knew me when I was little. But the good thing about it is that God gets the glory out of this. And I remember, you know, I've been resaved almost over 15 years. And the thing about it, I remember at the cookouts, you know, I used to kind of run from Linda, you know, my sister, because I know she was going to give me a word of God. When I wasn't walking with the Lord, I would run from her. And I knew she was going to catch me eventually, but she had catch me, and she had never condemned me, but she would always say something to give me something with the Lord, you know. But I would run from her and John. That's all. But I knew they would catch up, you know. But you know, now, you know, in my walk with the Lord, you know, I was looking for her, so that way when she give me something, I have something for her, you know what I mean. And I want to thank my sister Sandra and, you know, my brother Jamie for having that child, you know. And I'm just grateful to be a part of this family. You know, it's a special family, you know, because I've been knowing them ever since I was little. And it's like, you know, Sandra gave me a lot of beatings. Never forget about that. But I'm, she is resting, you know, and resting in peace that when the Lord comes, you know, I know, because when I fast and I pray, the Lord is going to say, well done, my faithful servant. Well done. And I am so grateful to be a part of her. And I just want to keep my righteousness so that way I can go to heaven too. Amen. Amen. Amen.
How you doing? Oh, I'm so short. I'm Nicole. I'm going to miss my Aunt Linda. She was a matriarch. I'm not going to say nobody in this world, but those Sachibel sisters showed love, strength. They held that glue together. You know, I hope that, you know, for the rest of us that are left here, that we can embrace that, because that's the part that I'm going to miss. You understand? I'm going to miss my aunts. You know, I got a few of them left, and one thing I can say about my aunts, like, nobody can love like the Sachibel sisters, and that's all I have.
Good morning, church. I give honor to God and Bishop Borders, the ministers on the roster, to my family, the Haynes and the Hampton family. My name is Larry Hamilton, and I really love Linda and my uncle. Where you see Linda, you will see my Uncle John. She loved to dance. She loved music. She loves her family. And I say to the family, for those who don't know the Lord, to get to know the Lord, because he is good. Call one another. If you haven't heard from the family members, give them a call. See how they're doing. Let them know that you love them. And I pray that God would strengthen each and every one of you all. Those who are traveling near and far, that God will give you traveling mercy to your destination. God bless you. Thank you.
I'm not much of a public speaker, but I will for my grandma. I just wish she was here to meet her great-grandson, yes, Grayson Michael, but she met him while he was still in the belly. I'm just like remembering everything. Grandma always had snacks for us in her purse, even if they taste like perfume and lipstick. She always had something for us, and I'll never forget when she always used to get us like the dollar slice pizza and was always like, you know, you better not tell your brother or sister or you're not gonna get no more pizza because I ain't got enough for all of y'all, so. Here, take this doll and go get your slice. So, I'm just gonna miss her. And I just wanted to come up and just share something that was like, we all remember her little church candies and stuff. And just like all those memories of her coming over to watch us and make us like home-cooked french fries, best fries. And she taught me how to make cabbage, so. And you know she make the best cabbage. Now it's me. But, yeah, I just wanted to say that.
Thank you guys. Hello, family. Love you guys so much. It's her Jamel. Extended family over there. Extended family, everybody, thanks for coming out. I had the greatest mom in the world, as we all know. Thank God for giving me 42 years to be with her. You know, she's gonna be really, truly missed, you know? She just did a great job. She had an open heart. She loved everybody, even when people did her wrong. She still had that open heart and still loved them, you know? And big up to my dad so much. Towards the end, my dad worked so, and my sister, all you guys did, but my dad worked so hard towards the end, made sure she got her medicine, he changing her diaper. My dad loved the hell out of his mom, his wife, and she's like the best, and that's like true love. Also, this little guy used to come over to the house, make sure his grandmother drinks water. She wasn't drinking that much water. Grandma, you need to drink some water. Grandma, please, you want to stay alive, right? Yes, Trevor, but everyone who put in that work, and even once we didn't put in that work, we all are so busy in our lives, and y'all hearts was there, and I know it was there. You know, I'm sad. I'm going to miss my mom. She's like one of the greatest ladies, you know. She's such to everybody. She just want everyone to love each other, you know. My aunt right there, a Sidra, a Pat. I'm sorry about your sister, because that was y'all's. Y'all loved her before I came along. And my dad, that was your wife, your lady before I came along. So my heart goes out to all y'all, you know. I just love everybody. And thanks for coming out, you know. My mom was the best. Now she's just resting and she's just going to be missed, you know. Amen. Thank you, everybody, you know.
Amen. Good morning, everybody. I'm a friend of the family. Brother John from the old neighborhood. There weren't too many bright things that we could see on a daily basis in the neighborhood that we grew up in. But one of the bright things that we could see, and that I could see every Sunday, was Miss Linda and Mr. John going out for church. And they would have their finest on, as my mom would say. And again, growing up in the neighborhood that we grew up in, weren't too many nice things or two things to look forward to, or couples to look forward to share black love. And if I had to say, if there was anybody in our neighborhood that showed that, it was Miss Linda and Mr. John. John, you're my brother.
No doubt, bro.
I just want to say I love you.
Love you too, man.
And my heart goes out to the family. Condolences.
Love you, bro. Love you too, man.
Is 2 seconds. Greatest mother on the face of this earth, that give the greatest butt whoopings on the face of this earth back in the days, because she can do that. Love you, Mom.
What beautiful, beautiful remark. Amen. I think that's a good time for everybody to stand on their feet and give God a hand of praise for Mama Linda Haynes. Put your hands together for this beautiful woman, this wonderful soul. Thank you, Lord God. And I know at the repast that you'll have other things that you can share and many stories that will be floating around. And that's what we do. We keep the memory alive. Amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank God for those wonderful remarks. You may be seated. And long after you've left here today, I hope that something will stick out in your mind. We're going to ask Shantia, did I say that right? Shantia Little, to come forth with the acknowledgments and the obituary. And following her, we'll have another solo from Demetria.
Hey, y'all. So first and foremost, I want to thank you to all the family, friends, loved ones that have reached out and provided support during our time. Also acknowledging our pallbearers who will help escort Grandma, Uncle Harold, Junior, Josh, Marcel, Shane and Lucky. We also have a couple of cards as well. Not gonna go through everything, but read a couple of them out here. No one knew her like you. No one loved her like you. Your wife's love will never leave you. Memories of her will bless you always. And the everyday things that still carry the tenderness of her life, thinking of you. Heartfelt condolences. Praise always. Thank you. This one. I know it hurts and you miss her, but every day that you go out into the world and live as well as you can is a tribute to your mom and the happiness she wants for you. Hope that thought brings some comfort and peace to your heart in the days to come. With sympathy, with all my love and prayers to you all, Cookie. That's my Cookie. Also, I will read the obituary. On March 6, 1944, Eleanor and Charles Sachabelle welcomed Linda Gail Sachabelle. When she was born, there must have been music playing because one thing Linda loved to do was dance. And I'm not the only person that said that today, so there's truth in that. Growing up in Boston, Linda was practically a local celebrity with her sisters. Everyone knew about them Sachabelle women, each one as beautiful as the last. This Boston Public School educated gem was later taken off the market by Harold Hampton Sr. deceased and gave birth to Harold Hampton Jr., Kevin Hampton deceased, and Sarita Hampton. Although that love didn't last, in 1968, she met the man of her dreams, John Haynes Sr. Together, Linda and John were the epitome of beautiful black love. If you knew anything about the two of them, when they stepped out, they looked like the cover of Jet magazine. United, they welcomed John Haynes Jr. and my favorite pain in the butt, RIP, Paris Haynes as well. On June 9th, 1989, the two officially became Mr. and Mrs. John and Linda Haynes, fusing their families together with Harold Hampton, Sarita Hampton, Sheila Horn, John Haynes Jr., and Paris. During her life, if she wasn't dancing in her hot pants, she was helping somebody. She always taken somebody somewhere for something. Her benevolence knew no limits. Linda even took in an elderly woman sleeping on a bench and helped the lady find her family. Our angel has found her wings. Linda has joined her siblings in the afterlife and reunited with her sons, Paris and Kevin. She leaves behind her loving husband, Grandpa John, daughters, Sarita, Sheila, and her husband, Robert, sons, Harold Jr., Harold Hampton, John Haynes, along with grandchildren, Shantia, Joshua, Tishana, Shavante, Marquise, Quita, Sal, Cynthia, Trey, Trevor, and the youngest, Jacob. Also, my favorite aunties, Sandra, Aunt Pat, and Aunt Juanita. Her memory will live on through each niece, nephew, cousin, family member, and friend. And although today may be a sad day on earth, heaven is rejoicing because they have welcomed another angel. Thank you guys for coming. We have felt your love through and through. Your support, your kindness, your generosity, just being here, your prayers, your hugs, the tears, everything with all of us. We would not be able to get through this without being the Sachabelles that we are. I moved here to have this love, and whether or not they are here, we are going to continue this. We're going to do like Nikki said. We're going to keep everyone together. We're going to keep having the cookouts because those were my best memories in the summer when we would take over Franklin Park or take over somebody's backyard, take over behind on Elm Hill when they used to let us have cookouts behind there and have a good old time. We're going to continue that one way or another. I love you guys. Thank you.
If you wanna know where I'm going, soon. If anybody asks you where she's going, going up yonder, I'm going up yonder, I'm going up yonder to be with my Lord. Oh, I'm going up yonder, I'm going up yonder.
she can take the pain, the heartaches that it will bring. She's going to see her Savior face to face. Sorry, y'all. If you want to know where she's going, where she's going soon, if she could take the pain, the heartache that it brings. She's going to see her Savior face to face. Oh, she's going up yonder. She's going up yonder. She's going up yonder to be with her.
Getting all choked up, lost my note, but it's all good, because I was remembering when I would always see Aunt Linda, Uncle John at almost everything we had in Connecticut. But what is sticking to me the most is when I was going, I was taking up classes to be a barber, and I needed money. I needed help to get my kid. But I know, if anything, I can make one phone call to Boston, and I can get whatever I need from whomever. And Aunt Pat said, Linda and John gave $75. I said, what? They did? And the thing, I was so shocked, because I'm closer to Aunt Pat and Aunt Sandra. And not saying I didn't love Aunt Linda and Uncle John, but I love them. But I was just shocked, because I normally would ask just like Aunt Pat and Aunt Sandra and Lucky. But I was so moved. That will stay with me forever, because at the time that I really, really needed this, and that it was, I don't like asking for help. So at this time when I really, really need the most, I could not help but I gotta call her. I gotta call her, and I have to thank her. So just, that was choking me up. So just, as Shanti was saying, like, and I can always come to Boston or make a phone call or whatever and get love from my family. I will come here when I'm frustrated, when I just gotta get away from Connecticut. I'm gonna come here to Boston to get the love from the Satchabells, because that's where it's at. I love y'all.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Let us just bow our heads again as we go before the throne. Father God, I just thank you for this day. No other day but this day will be remembered for what you're doing here today. Touch the family, Lord God, in every way that they need to be touched. Father God, I thank you that you would hide me behind the cross, that I may decrease and you may increase. And I give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. I just thank God for the honor and the privilege to be before you this morning. Some of you might know me. and some of you may not, but my name is Reverend Pamela Haley Gillard, a.k.a. Cookie Haley from JP. Hallelujah. And I just thank God. I thank God for the Sachibel sisters. We grew up knowing about these beautiful women, and our families were connected, and I thank God for that. And I thank God for the privilege of today. And when I look out and I see her legacy, her children and her grandchildren, there's such greatness in this room. I don't know if you realize that yet, but you are great. And some of those seeds were planted by your mother and your grandmother. I want to share just for a few moments from the scriptures. I look at the program and I see one of the scriptures has already been used, and that's okay. But I'm going to be reading from the first one is Isaiah 58:7. Share your food with the hungry and give shelter to the homeless. Give clothes to those who need them, and do not hide from relatives who need your help. Proverbs 31:10-12. A wife of noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her and lacks nothing of value. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches her hand to the needy. Her husband is respected at the city gate, where he takes his seat among the elders of the land. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise her in the gates. You're here today because you've been touched. You've been touched by God, and your life has been touched by Sister Linda. As a wife, a mom, a grandmother, a sibling, an auntie, a cousin, extended family, or friend, I thank you so much for showing up for her today, just as she showed up for you in the past. Mama Linda, she's a queen, so she deserves to have a title. And I'm going to call her Mama Linda today. Is that all right? She loved life and enjoyed every bit of it. We thank God for the 80 years of life, a good life, a full life of love and service for her family and others. Her and her husband were like two peas in a pod. When you saw one, you saw the other. Thank God for precious memories. As I shared earlier, when I came here from Louisiana, Hurricane Katrina, I met John, and then I met Linda. And they were such a blessing to us. So loving, so kind. And I'll never forget that. And my husband and I, we're here for you, John, and your family. She will be remembered for love and compassion to those less fortunate. The scriptures tell us that children are a heritage of the Lord, and that includes grandchildren as well. They're an extension of that heritage. And she loved them and enjoyed them so much. God brings children in our lives in so many different ways. She had other children, spiritual children, neighborhood children. But God brings them in so that this is his reward to her. She was not just a good person, but a woman who knew God. Amen? I thank God that the things that she learned, she passed on to others. You know, the way the world is operating now, everything is about self. What I can do for me, what I can get for me. But I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about self-care in terms of your health and rest and caring for your body. But I'm talking about how we can walk down the street and turn our head from some of the things that we see. That wasn't Sister Linda. She embraced those that were less fortunate. She embraced those that didn't have others to love on them. And you know, Mama Linda couldn't have made it without God, and neither can you. Amen? Do you believe that today? You need a Savior. Hallelujah. And if you haven't found him, that's all right. You're in the right place today. But if you know him, keep on holding on to his unchanging hand, because the times are going to get worse. They're not going to get any better. I'm not going to stand up here and lie to you. But because we have a relationship with Jesus, he will hold on to us. He will keep us, just like Mama Linda held on to each of you. Oh, I thank God so much. I thank God that we have a Savior that we can cry out to. Thank you, Lord. If you know what I'm talking about, just give the Lord a wave. Just wave your hand. Sometimes you don't even have to say anything. Hallelujah. You know, one of the things, as we could see when we were having the viewing, we could see what a beautiful and elegant woman Mama Linda was. She dressed to impress. She really did, without even trying. But her dress went beyond the outward appearance, what met the eye. She wore garments of humility, garments of love, garments of praise, garments of compassion, garments of conviction and forgiveness. She wore those garments. How many women do you know that would randomly go to a funeral to someone that they didn't know just because they heard about the tragedy in their life? That was her. Her legacy of compassion and love will be remembered. I can see it in you. I can see it in some of you. She wouldn't want you to just remember her. She'd want you to go a little bit further. She'd want you to imitate. She'd want you to show love to those that weren't so lovable. She'd want you to pick up the phone and call that family member that gets on everybody's nerves, but she'd want you to reach out to them. A family suffers greatly when a matriarch and a queen leaves. The fabric of the family breaks down. Relationships can falter and unravel, but it doesn't have to be that way. Love one another as God has loved you, as Mama Linda has loved you. Amen? You could come to know the God that she came to know if you don't already know her. Her story has come to the end, the final curtain. But your story is still being written. How will it be written? What will you change? what impacted you from Mama Linda that you will incorporate in your life, that you will pass on to your children and your children's children. Everybody has to come this way. I don't care who you are. Everybody, there's a time to be born and there's a time to die. For everyone, you have to make a decision. You have to make a decision whether you're going to serve God or whether you're not. He'll never force his hand to you. But I'm telling you, in the blink of an eye, your life could change. Things happen. Life be lifing. Everything goes on. But there's a breaking of a new day. So if I could just leave a few nuggets with you this afternoon, I'd encourage you to know God for yourself. It's not enough to say the God that Mama Linda knew, the God that you need to know. Hallelujah. He has to be your personal Savior. Hallelujah. If you don't know, ask him, what is your purpose? You're not just on this earth to look good. You have a purpose, and God has a plan for you. Ask him, what do you have for me to do? And then when he tells you, just do it. Always show kindness, even when others are not so kind to you. It's not easy, but it's doable. We can do it. Forgive others, because we need Jesus to forgive us. Remember to extend a hand to the homeless and to those that are less fortunate, even if they're in your own family. Let's figure this out, family. We can do it. In Isaiah 1:17, the Message translation, it reads like this. Learn to do good, work for justice, help the down and out, stand up for the homeless, go to bat for the defenseless. Let's argue this out. Honor Mama Linda, honor God in the way you walk, in the way you talk, in the way you live. We all have a part to play, amen? Even in this day, with tears rolling down your eyes, sadness in your heart because Mama Linda is no longer on the earth with us. Her spirit will always live on. But you can have that personal relationship with Jesus that will ensure you that you can see her again. I don't know about you, but I wouldn't want to live on this earth and go through all the things that we've had to go through as black men, black women, children coming up, and die and go to hell. But it doesn't have to be that way. So I'd just like you to take a minute, because I know Mama Linda would want this. I'd like to extend this invitation. It's an invitation. You don't need any money. It doesn't matter where you've been, where you live, who you know. All you have to do is just say yes to the Lord. So I'd like you to just close your eyes for a moment, because this is personal. Every head bow, every eye closed. And it's so simple. If you don't know Jesus Christ and the pardon of your sins, in this moment, in this time, in this celebration of life, just open your heart and ask God to forgive you of your sin. Ask God to come into your heart and to cleanse you, to reveal his plan and his purpose for you, to help you live out the rest of your days. We can't do it alone. And so if you've never accepted Christ as your Savior and you want to live a better life, you want that life, just where you are, raise your hand. Just tell God yes. That's all he's looking for, is a yes. Sometimes we think we got to do this and we got to do that. No, all we have to do is say yes. Yes to you, Lord. Yes to your will. Doesn't matter how old you are or how young you are. Just tell the Lord yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your presence on today. We thank you, Lord, for the life and the legacy of Mama Queen Linda. Thank you, Lord God, for allowing her to bless our lives. We give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. In Jesus' name. And I thank you all for being here this morning. I really do. I thank you for honoring her. And now we are in the hands of the funeral directors and our ushers. And if there's anybody that wants prayer or you just need a closer walk with the Lord, we're here to pray with you. God bless you. Final viewing in the vestibule. Thank you. And please remain seated until the ushers direct you.
Whether you saint, sinner, rich, poor, black, white, doesn't make any difference. How many of you can just raise your hands with me and say, you know that God has smiled on me. Woke you up this morning, didn't it? You didn't wake yourself up. Why don't you turn around and shake somebody's hand and tell them God has smiled on me. Shake your hands again and tell them this, I won't take it back. God has I get a witness here?
Smile on me. Yes, set me free.
Looking back over these 25 years, couldn't have made it. Without the Lord, we won't have a silver or a gold wheel. Whether you saint, sinner, rich, poor, black, white, doesn't make any difference. How many of you can just raise your hands with me and say, you know that God has smiled on me. Woke you up this morning, didn't it? You didn't wake yourself up. Why don't you turn around and shake somebody's hand and tell them God has smiled on me. Shake your hands again and tell them this, I won't take it back. God has, can I get a witness here?
Smiled on me.
quieter. Let me hear you say it. God, God has smiled on me.
Smiled on me.
He has set me free. Testimony. He's the cause of my joy today.